coming up next, we present this heavyweight championship fight between Cain Velasquez and Junior Dos Santos. Well, for a long time, he's been mentioned with the baddest men on the planet. For a long time, though, the title fight eluded him. Not anymore. Here he is, the number one heavyweight contender, finally making this walk and cracking a smile. He's waited a long time for this. He's not expecting a 25-minute war. He believes he has the power and the skills to get this thing done quickly. I guess we'll find out. So here he is making his way to the octagon for another heavyweight title defense. This has been the baddest man on the planet now for several years, and he has taken on all comers more often than not, leaving them twitching on the canvas. Knockout power for days. The question is tonight, with a challenge like this, can he walk out the way he came in as the undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world? Of the tape for this heavyweight championship fight. Dos Santos is 5 years the elder. He is 3 inches taller. The reach is identical. To get us started, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Dan Mergliotta. This is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Toyota Center in Houston, Texas, it's time! 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC heavyweight championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a boxer holding a professional record of 21 wins, 9 losses. He stands 6 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 238 pounds. Fighting out of Salvador Bahia, Brazil, presenting the challenger, Junior Cigano. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a wrestler, holding a professional record of 14 wins, 3 losses. He stands 6 feet 1 inch tall, weighing in at 240 pounds. Fighting out of San Jose, California, ladies and gentlemen, presenting the reigning, defending UFC heavyweight champion of the world, Cain!
This is for the UFC championship. I want you to be in the commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. You want a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves, back your corners, come out fighting.
All right, here we go with round one, or you could call it round 12, between two guys whose careers will forever be linked. Two of the best heavyweights to ever do it, your guy Cain Velasquez against JDS.
Junior Dos Santos and Cain Velasquez are two of the greatest fighters the heavyweight division has ever seen. And these two dudes have left everything in the octagon. They've left a part of themselves together in each octagon, every city they've been in, Las Vegas, Houston, Texas, Anaheim, California. Tonight, they get to do it one more time. So sit back, enjoy yourself. It's about to be a great ride.
Well, as a lot of people, oh, nice job to defend the takedown and scramble to his feet. Velasquez gets caught with that punch. His chin is held up thus far. Got to shore up the defense here, though. All right, single collar tie now. Oh, stuffs the takedown without issue. Straight right, he misses. Well, that didn't take long. Dos Santos's hook shot gets blocked. The defense saw that one coming.
Big, powerful punch land. Now he gets back to the ring. Turns him up. Hook either.
Oh! Now goes in and secures the takedown.
He might have got him on the choke. Oh, nice.
Oh, really nice work to keep busy off of his back as he lands some more offense here for Buck. Well, these are some excellent ground and pound strikes here, DC. There's an efficiency with which he operates in these situations.
He knows exactly when to throw, exactly when to hold, and it's allowing him to really control the grappling aspect of the fight.
There's a song there, right? Know when to hold him,
know when to hold him. Yep, absolutely.
Well, the ground and pound has been on point tonight. Good work here by Velasquez. Well, he's got his back now. All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. Lands with the ground and pound.
He's putting him in exactly the positions he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here. And he understands, being a veteran of so many fights, that as long as he's on top, he's winning. He feels like he's winning here.
Oh, lands with the ground and pound strike.
Oh, right to the mouth.
Just over 2 minutes to go. Well, working pretty effectively from the top here. Nice ground and pound by Velasquez. Outstanding ground and pound here. Somewhat of a lost art in MMA, at least in terms of making sure that every strike counts. Not an issue for him.
He's making every single one of them count. He is not pity-patting. He's not touching. Every punch that lands, he wants you to feel it.
Well, that didn't take long. Dos Santos' lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. Good work from the top here by Velasquez. All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here.
Sound strike on the ground. Well, not ideal to spend this much time on the bottom, but...
You got to watch him attack his submissions. He throws the legs up to try to get a triangle choke here. Watch triangle, watch triangle. There he is. He's moving to the finishing position. Now watch, he goes parallel.
Nicely done.
You see him put himself into the half guard? Like the control, yep.
Velasquez has got full mount now. Seconds left. Oh, his opponent's squirming like a fish out of water now. The ground and pound is on point. This could very well be the beginning of the end.
This could be the beginning of the end. We've seen some really good ground and pound fighters. This young man is as good as any we've ever seen.
Horn sounds for the end of round one. All right, there's the end of the round. So it was a huge strike to the head that stunned his opponent and nearly got him out of there.
Yeah, that was a big moment. A big strike lands, his opponent's on wobbly legs. That is exactly what you want to see as you're walking back to your stool. Your opponent staggering back to his corner and being hopeful that he can get it back together before the start of the next round.
Down. Here we go. Round two. Cain Velasquez versus Junior Dos Santos.
Big punch land over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
Dos Santos is kicked to the body. That one blocked. Stuffs the takedown there. How good is his takedown defense? Oh!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. Right hand punch.
Hand and knee.
Oh, that was a really nice takedown.
All right, full guard here, DC. We'll see how soon he tries to pass.
Well, he needs to be passing immediately. In the full guard is where you are in most danger as a top fighter because they have all of their submissions.
Right.
They have the guillotine. They have the armbar. They have the kimuras. They have all their locks when they're in the full guard. So if you pass, you really do limit the danger that you're in from the top position.
89 total strikes have now found the mark for Cain Velasquez. Well, two out of every three strikes, finding the target, landing with 67% accuracy against JDS.
He's back in the close position. This is where he has done a ton of his work here. Punch, punch, punch to the head of the clinch.
Nice punch there by Velasquez. JDS back to work with the leg kick. Looking to land the right hand, he misses. All right, he'll engage in a single collar tie, and they separate. Velasquez's torso, specifically that right side, has absorbed a lot of damage tonight. And here comes the purple, the black, and blue. A definite bruise starting to form on that right side. Continues to mix it up, going to the head, mixing in some body shots.
Oh! He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Oh! Huge right hand! That knee might have landed there. Oh!
Every time these guys come together, man, you just hear the punches and everything landing. Both very powerful.
Velasquez gets the takedown there. And he's back up again. So the takedowns have been there, as have the get-ups. All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
Man, how fun is this to watch as he continues to dole out damage with the ground and pound.
Take it back to the days of guys like Mark Coleman, just beating people up in the ground and pound. This guy is a throwback fighter, and he's very fun to watch.
Yeah, the Godfather would be proud. All right, 2 minutes now to go in the round. Velasquez ground and pound from half guard. Lands the ground and pound strike. A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. Well, he continues to manhandle him here on the ground. 90 seconds now to go in round two. All right, so he's got the body locked down here, DC, or so it appears. This is not a guy you want anywhere near your back. Well, his corner was pretty urgent after round one. A little bit lackluster there in that opening round. He has certainly picked up the pace here, and as a result, he has taken control of this second round. Velasquez gets another takedown. The question now, what will he do with it?
Oh, nice right hand.
Under a minute now to go. Bottom fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head or he's going to get blasted.
Oh, he's got the ground and pound going now. Well, that didn't take long. Dos Santos' lower jaw looking extremely swollen now. working off of his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. All right, he's got side control here, DC. You know, he's got a lot of different submissions in his arsenal once this fight gets to the ground. All right, so he's sort of turtled up here. Not great body language. Perhaps he's trying to bait him in a little bit. So a crowd-pleasing 5 minutes in the books. DC, take us through some of the highlights.
Punch after punch landed right on his opponent's face. Did a great job of finding his target, locking in, and then getting his fist to the target in that round.
Holds up, and there comes the separation now. Well, he's up, but oh, is he hurt. Stuffs the takedown, no problem. Oh, that's a good strike there by Dos Santos.
That was a thudding leg kick.
A single collar tie, and a nice job at least staying upright on that. Velasquez gets hit with that hook shot there. He's got to be careful to not allow the offense to follow up here.
Right hand punch to the clinch.
Wow, that right punch has been the money weapon for him tonight, and he landed it again there.
If his opponent does not change something, he will continue to throw the strike until he makes it. Stop throwing.
Well, not a good sign for the opposition here. 148 total strikes have landed for Cardio King. Yeah, looks a little wobbly on his feet.
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
And they separate.
Big punch lands in the middle.
Oh, collar tie.
Look at the force behind that leg.
Ooh. Again, they clinch. Man, oh, the master of the transition. Nice scramble. All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. A lot of top pressure being applied here. 3 minutes to go in round three. Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. Oh, man, this ground and pound is good. Probably my favorite striking realm in MMA, and he's as good as it gets.
The problem is his opponent is not controlling his posture. He's allowing his opponent to get up, and when he does, he creates this space to land these beautiful ground and pound combinations.
A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. All right, so inside the open guard of his opponent, you got to be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. Ground and pound strike there now. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Oh, he is up, but man, is he hurt. A finish could come here at any time. Stuffs the takedown, no problem. Well, we wondered earlier why there weren't as many body strikes. He's making up for lost time here. Shot to the body connects, and that bears watching. That's going to hurt this opponent. Single collar tie now. Punches blocked. Velasquez gets caught with that punch. Not the easiest guy in the world to hit, but he got caught there. Stuffs that takedown attempt without issue. And they separate. He engages in a single collar tie. Trying to kick the leg out.
Oh, man, look at that. Picture perfect. Got to the leg, got to his position, got another beautiful takedown.
Well, you got to be working off of your back. He's certainly doing so here. Nice punch. Into the final minute of this championship fight. Oh, nice work from the bottom. Tags him with the punch. Gets up again here, but hurting. Nice punch by Dos Santos. Oh!
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
He's got that tie clinch. We'll see what he can do with it. Oh, nice work to get the takedown there. Good entry by Velasquez. Side control now. Well, as usual, suffocating work from the top here by Cain Velasquez. These are some big punches here from the top, DC. He hasn't needed to enter his opponent's guard yet, and he may not have to.
He may not have to, but he's doing a really good job of being aware. There's danger when you're standing in the top guard like that. You gotta watch the uptake. Notice how he deals with his hip when he goes to land the strike.
Well, he had a lot more than a puncher's chance coming in. Big knockdown for him in the previous round. DC, talk us through the highlight.
He got in his opponent's face, landed that big punch that put his opponent flat on his back. He couldn't get the finish. But if he lands one more time just like that, he will get the victory. Damage is about to start.
Well, pretty good work off of the bottom here by Sagano. Oh, man, that left side is getting beat up now. Look at the redness there.
All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here.
Good, solid strike on the ground. Postured up there, gained some valuable separation.
And now, the grounded pound starts.
Well, the grounded pound is there once again. Strong work here by Cain Velasquez. Oh, useful strike on the ground, that was. Velasquez is looking to lock up an arm bar here.
Gotta be careful, armbar.
Continuing to try to manipulate the head here.
Now he falls back into the finishing position.
So there he is, the baddest man on the planet, UFC heavyweight champion of the world, a title that every heavyweight wants. He has it after the win by submission here tonight. He leaned on the grappling, and he got the job done in a big way.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Rogliakas called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 49 seconds of round number 4. For the winner by submission, and still the undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world, Cain Velasquez.
All right,
right, so we hear and still tonight, our UFC heavyweight champion came in with a lot of pressure, a lot of hype, and he successfully defends the title here tonight.
With all that pressure, he never changes his approach. He always does exactly what he says he's going to do,